You probably know that I put high value on the amount of materials we extract from the earth for the stuff that we do. Also, I am kind of a chemistry geek insofar that I absolutely love looking at the periodic table and figure out what certain elements are being used for. Also, a friend of mine sent me an email trying to explain to me that my emphasis on copper production might make my arguments easy to refute. I agree, so I am going to make a series of videos in which we examine just how much materials we extract, what we use them for, and how long they will last, and try to add some more context to my arguments. Perhaps we will find out new things that disprove some of the stuff I said earlier, which isn't bad. Our entry point in this endeavor is the USGS mineral commodity page. We work our way down the alphabet, starting with three metrics. The multiplier the USGS uses to address the figures, for instance 1,000 metric tons or 1,000,000 metric tons. Then we look at the latest annual production rate, which I normalize to metric tons. We look at the reserves, we also normalize to metric tons. And finally, we figure out how long we have until we run out of the resource with current means of extracting them economically. Because for the reserves, these are noted and economically recoverable in the USGS commodity page. This does not mean that they depict all available resources. We start off with one of the most used and recycled materials on the planet, aluminium. Now, I'm not interested in how much aluminium we produce in the end, but how much of the primary aluminium ore we extract. This ore is named bauxite. Not all of it is used to produce aluminium. Approximately 10% of it ends up in abrasives and products of the such like. Here we note that the USGS uses 1,000 metric tons for each figure, unless stated otherwise. Worldwide, we produce about 262 million metric tons of bauxite per year, and we have about 28 billion metric tons available to us with current economical means of extraction, and we will run out in about 107 years. Next we have antimony. Not all people know what we use this element for. Its primary uses are for flame retardants, alloys, like for batteries for instance, medicine, and as a neutron source for nuclear power. In the USGS commodity page summary for antimony, we can see that all figures are in metric tons. The annual production of antimony is 130,000 metric tons. We have about 1.5 million tons of reserves, and at this moment we will run out of antimony in about 12 years. Next we have arsenic. It won't surprise you that it has been used in pesticides for a long time, for instance. But it is also used in lasers and LEDs, as well as in PET scans, where the arsenic-74 isotope seems to be a better option over iodine-124 to locate tumors. All figures for arsenic are in metric tons. The annual production is a measly 36,500 tons, with an economically recoverable reserve of 730,000 metric tons, which will run out in about 20 years, if we continue using arsenic as we do today. And finally, we have one of the ugliest substances in the A range of the alphabet, asbestos. Asbestos has been used in buildings as a flame retardant, an insulator, general building material, and much more. Right now, asbestos is being banned from use all across the world as it has been proven to cause cancer. Asbestos is still being produced. Figures are in metric tons, and a considerable 2 million metric tons is being extracted per year. No real estimate about its reserves exist. And that concludes the first letter of the alphabet. I hope you enjoyed this small informative video. I will be making more as it is an interesting subject to explore, and it will give us some more insight in how quickly we are using up our worlds in terms of resource depletion. If you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, family and colleagues, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Thank you for watching.